Summary of nerve supply of the lower limb start by femoral nerve, root value lumbar 2, 3, and 4. The femoral nerve arises from the lumbar plexus inside the psoas major muscle in the abdomen. It enters the femoral triangle and gives many branches. Number 1, cutaneous branches, medial, intermediate cutaneous nerve of the thigh and the saphenous nerve. Then muscular branches to supply the following muscles: iliacus, sartorius, pectineus. Articular branches to the hip and the knee joints. Obturator nerve, same roots of the femoral nerve, lumbar 2, 3, and 4. It arises also from the lumbar plexus inside the psoas major in the abdomen and enter the canal with the obturator vessels, then gives the anterior and the posterior divisions. It gives the following branches: muscular to gracilis, adductor longus, adductor brevis, and adductor magnus. Articular branch to the hip and knee joints also. Cutaneous branch to the medial aspect of the thigh. This is the lumbar plexus, psoas major muscle removed here. This inside the abdomen, which gives two main branches. Lateral to psoas major is the femoral nerve, and the medial to the psoas major is the obturator nerve. Sciatic nerve from lumbar 4, 5, sacral 1, 2, and 3. It arises from the sacral plexus in the pelvis and ends at the back of the thigh by dividing into two terminals, tibial and the common peroneal nerves. It leaves the pelvis through greater sciatic foramen below the piriformis muscle. Branch of sciatic nerve, muscular branches to hamstring muscles and the ischial part or flexor part of the adductor magnus. Two terminals of sciatic nerve, tibial and the common, then articular branches to the hip joint. Sciatic nerve injury caused by either posterior dislocation to the hip joint or intramuscular injection in the wrong side of the gluteal region or penetrating wound in the gluteal region. Result of sciatic nerve injury, paralysis of hamstring muscles, all muscles of the leg and the foot, and deformity will be foot drop. Sensory loss of sensation below the knee except an area along the medial malleolus. This is the sciatic nerve that comes out from the pelvis through greater sciatic foramen below the piriformis muscle. It divides into two terminals at the back of the thigh into tibial and the common peroneal nerves. This is the sacral plexus inside the pelvis and it gives the sciatic nerve. Tibial nerve, sometimes it is called the medial popliteal, arises as one of two terminals of sciatic nerve. It enters the popliteal fossa and ends at the lower border of the popliteus muscle where it enters the back of the leg. Branches, cutaneous as sural nerve arises in the middle of the popliteal fossa and descends with short saphenous vein to the lateral aspect of the foot to reach the little toe. Muscular to the following muscles: gastrocnemius, plantaris, soleus, and popliteus muscles. Articular branches to the knee joint. This is the here tibial nerve, one of the two terminals of the sciatic. Change its name at the lower border of the gluteus to become posterior tibial nerve. Common peroneal nerve, sometimes it's called the lateral popliteal, arises as one of two terminals of sciatic nerve. It enters the popliteal fossa at the upper angle and passes around the neck of the fibula deep to the peroneus longus muscle and ends by dividing into two divisions, superficial and the deep peroneal nerves. Branches of common peroneal cutaneous branches, sural communicating and lateral cutaneous nerve of the calf. Articular branches to the knee joint. Terminal branches, superficial or musculocutaneous nerve, deep or anterior tibial nerve. This is the branches here of common peroneal. This is the superficial peroneal and this is the deep peroneal. The superficial peroneal arises at the lateral side of the neck of the fibula as soon as one of the two terminals of the common peroneal. It gives the muscular branches to peroneus longus and the brevis, cutaneous branches to the front of the leg and dorsum of the foot. The deep peroneal nerve arises as one of the two terminals of common peroneal at the neck of the fibula also. It ends in the dorsum of the foot by dividing into lateral and medial branches. Branches of the deep peroneal nerve give muscular two, tibialis anterior, extensor hallucis longus, extensor digitorum longus, and peroneus tertius muscle. Articular branches to the ankle joint, terminal branches, medial and the lateral divisions. Superficial and deep peroneal nerves here of common peroneal. This is around the neck of the fibula, superficial and the deep branches. Plantar nerves. Medial plantar nerve arises as one of two terminals of posterior tibial nerve. Gives the muscular branches to abductor hallucis, flexor hallucis brevis, flexor digitorum brevis, and first lumbrical muscle. Articular two intertarsal and tarso metatarsal joints. Lateral plantar nerve, it is the second terminal of tibial nerve and divides into superficial and deep branches. The branch of lateral plantar nerve muscular to all muscles of the foot except the muscles which are supplied by medial plantar nerve. Then articular two intertarsal and tarso metatarsal joints. This is the plantar nerve here. Between first and second layers, medial plantar nerve accompany the medial plantar artery. Lateral plantar nerve accompany the lateral plantar artery.